Hey, what's up, guys? Today, I'll show you a supernatural horror film, Belzebuth. Spoilers ahead, watch out and take care. The film begins with a priest walking in an empty and deserted place, while his voiceover plays, explaining why he was expelled from the Vatican. The number of demonic possessions in the 21st century increased exponentially, so the Pope ordered to investigate the possession cases, backed up by priests with experiences in exorcism and demonology. The scene then changes with a police detective, Ritter, with his wife and his newborn son in the hospital. Seconds later, the nurse comes in and informs them that she needs to take the baby for the final checkup. As the nurse leaves, Ritter receives a text from their chief, asking him to go back to the office. His wife understands his work, so she asks him not to take too long as they'll be waiting for him. As Ritter enters the elevator, a weird nurse exits and goes to take her shift. The strange nurse stares deeply into Ritter's son, not replying to the other nurse's instructions. She leaves the strange nurse to take care of the babies before leaving. The strange nurse then locks the door, pulls a scalpel from her bag, and repeatedly stabs Ritter's son. One of the parents sees this and quickly alerts everyone, including the police. They try to enter, but the door's locked. The strange nurse continuously stabs the newborn babies in the room. One of the police manages to break the glass with the fire extinguisher, but as they come in, it's too late already. The nurse has killed all the babies, and she stares at them with deadly eyes before slashing her throat. Not long after, Ritter receives the devastating news. Upon seeing his dead son, Ritter breaks down in tears. His cries of agony and pain echo in the room. Fast forward to 5 years later, an American paranormal investigator, Franco, receives a phone call in the middle of the night, informing him about a mass shooting in a kindergarten in Mexico. On the other hand, Anne, one of the new mothers in the hospital 5 years ago, comes home and hears the news about the mass shooting. She immediately turns off the television as her son, Tommy, comes out from his room and tells her that he had a nightmare. At this time, Ritter also watches the news and immediately leaves his house. Ritter arrives at the crime scene, and his partner informs him about the details. The killer is a high school student killing most kindergartens, before shooting his brains out. The motive is still unknown, but there's a possibility it might be connected to drugs that the police found in the locker. However, Ritter cannot help but curse their chief, as he notices that the case is similar to what happened in the hospital 5 years ago. One officer brings in the killer's mother and bluntly asks her if her son uses drugs. They show him the weeds they found in his backpack and the weapons. The mourning mother denies such accusations, so Ritter kindly asks her to sign the release form so they can enter their house and search through the killer's belongings. Later that day, Ritter interviews Anne's sister, the mother of one of the victim kids. She tells them about a weird man dressed in black that approached her days ago. He was old and had a hoodie covering his head. He told Anne's sister that something terrible would happen to her nephew and son, and that only he could protect them. Ritter asks her to describe this man, and she pictures him as a bald old man with satanic symbols tattooed on his head. The sister knows the man isn't from their place, but he has told her 5 more tragedies will happen. After the interview, Ritter faces the media and answers their questions. Unbeknownst to him, the priest shown at the beginning of the film watches from afar. Just then, Franco and his team arrive to get the photographs and evidence. Not long after, the police partner shows the kindergarten killer's laptop, implying that the kid might be in a satanic cult. However, Ritter shuts down his idea, as the partner only bases it on the laptop's background wallpaper. He changes the subject and informs Ritter that there are no traces of drug in the victim's body. Hence, they cannot frame him anymore with drugs that the partner hid in his bag. At this time, Franco and his team find something else while investigating the room where the kindergarten killer shot his brain out. The following day, the school lights flicker for a moment as a janitress does something to the power supply. The janitress comes out of the locker room with electrical wires wrapped around her. One of the parents' behavior alerts the lifeguard, so he immediately tries to stop her, but the janitress replies by bolting him. The kids in the water scream in fear as they try to get out. She stares at the kids with deadly eyes before dropping herself into the water. Ritter wakes up from the sound of his phone vibrating. As he answers it, the person on the other line informs him about the tragic event. At the crime scene, Ritter finally meets Franco, who informs him about the pattern that they discovered and possibly replicated in the pool. Franco shows him the fingerprints they found using a blacklight, the identical prints found in the hospital the night Ritter's son was murdered. Ritter gets offended that his son is brought up and accuses Franco of being paid to torment him. However, Franco replies that there is a clear pattern about what happened in the hospital and what's happening now, and Ritter might be the key to uncovering the mystery. The partner interferes before they get physical. He tells them that a woman recognized the man with tattoos, and Franco informs Ritter of the priest's name, who turns out to be an excommunicated priest for performing satanic rituals in Rome, and he was seen in the hospital 3 days after Ritter's son was killed. He was also seen on the grounds on the day of the school shooting. Later that day, Franco shows Ritter and his partner the fingerprints all across the room, explaining that it doesn't match with anyone. He also lets them hear the sounds coming from a room that his team soundproofed. This means that there are no airs or drafts that will enter or exit that room, so it's expected that they should not hear anything. However, their equipment captures a baby's cries, which is improbable. The following day, Ritter and his partner enter the fortune teller's house despite her protest. They tempt the fortune teller that they will erase her criminal file if she helps them. Franco asks her about the priest, and Ritter adds that if they do not find him soon, he will continue killing innocent kids, and probably her daughter too. The fortune teller informs them that the symbols on the priest's head are used for black magic. So left with no choice, she decides to help for the sake of her daughter. As she reads the tarot cards, she informs the trio that one of them is gonna die. But Ritter is skeptical and dismisses it. Things suddenly get thrown out, followed by the fortune teller's daughter's screams. As they enter her room, they find everything levitating and her bed shaking uncontrollably. It ends as soon as Ritter saves the child. Despite that, the fortune teller yells at them to leave. As she calms down her daughter, she tells Ritter to make peace with the Lord. The following day, Anne and her son Tommy are on the way to the theater when the priest appears and kidnaps her son before getting into a van. The bystanders can only murmur as Anne lies on the ground after being tased. One of the bystanders watches the van drive away before entering the theater and detonating himself. Later that day, Ritter and Franco are in charge of another mass murder. While investigating, one of the rescuers manages to find a survivor. Ritter and the two immediately rush to the survivor. With her remaining strength, the survivor informs them about the priest from the Church of Children, referring to the same priest they're looking for. After searching about the church, the partner informs them that it specializes in single mothers, orphans, and abandoned kids, and was founded 6 years ago. Franco doesn't want to waste any time and tells Ritter to drive him to the Church of Children. The night darkens as they arrive at the Church of Children, vandalized by insults and curses. They barge in and discover that the place has been completely abandoned. They find sacramental pieces of Christ vandalized with blood and crosses turned upside down. There are also satanic symbols on the walls and floors, drawn using blood. While investigating the place, a baby's laugh echoes, followed by a crib suddenly moving by itself. It bumps into a door leading to a room, where they find a giant cross with a broken porcelain statue of Christ. As they approach it, they cannot deny its foul smell. Flies are flying around as if the figure is a decaying human body. Ritter and Franco walk closer to it when the statue suddenly rises, and a devil's voice echoes in the room as he speaks to them. The devil laughs maniacally as he says he has many names, and his son is ready to walk among the humans. It turns out that this devil is called Belzebuth, the enemy of Christ, who promised to reincarnate himself in a new corpse to kill the reincarnation of Christ. This resulted in horrible mass slaughters, including the crusade, and possessing and killing many humans, so as to ensure that the reincarnations of Christ and his disciples would not walk on the earth. Ritter asks about the priest's whereabouts, but Belzebuth replies that he will give them the information in exchange for a child sacrificed. He also promises not to return for 1,000 years for one human life, but Ritter firmly refuses as he's not a murderer. So Belzebuth uses his guilt and creates a manifestation of Ritter's wife who left him after the death of their son. Baby's cries are heard as Belzebuth offers to bring Ritter's wife back to life. Despite Franco's continuous warning not to listen to the devil, Ritter doesn't care as he turns around and finds his wife holding her child. As Ritter faces his late wife, she gives him their baby, but to his horror, it is a decayed corpse full of worms. At this time, Belzebuth frees himself and is about to attack Franco from behind, but he shoots the porcelain statue, shattering it into pieces. Devastated after the discovery, Ritter attacks Franco, punching him in the face. Suddenly, the priest appears and tases him. The following day, Ritter wakes up with handcuffs and the priest in the flesh before him. Ritter is shocked to remember how he punched Franco to death last night. The priest shows him live footage of Franco and Anne and her son recovering, giving him a sigh of relief that he didn't kill him. They exit the abandoned plane, revealing that they are in an aircraft bunyard, where the priest explains Belzebuth's plan to stop the reincarnation of Christ. This reveals why Ritter's son was killed years ago by a possessed nurse, as one of the newborn babies was the reincarnation of St. Paul. It's also revealed that the teenager who committed mass murder in kindergarten killed the reincarnation of John the Baptist. After 2,000 years, Christ was reborn for the third time. He was now reborn in the body of Tommy. Ritter finally realizes everything as he digests the priest's explanation while looking at Anne and Tommy in a room. Later that day, it is presumed that Franco is already informed by the priest about what's happening. So to get more help, Ritter contacts his partner and tells him everything. That day, the partner travels to the aircraft bunker to an underground tunnel with the group. They all go down, while the partner stays behind to meet them on the other side of the tunnel. They soon reach the end, where they must choose between cells to proceed. Tommy refuses to walk any further as he's scared. Anne asks him why, and Tommy replies by pointing out to the right cell, subtly implying that it's the one to choose. As they walk deeper into the tunnel, Ritter curiously asks the priest why the Vatican expelled him. The priest shares that he bribed his soul to the devil for information, which doesn't sound good to everyone. But in his defense, it doesn't mean he's possessed. Franco confirms that they are two different things, which relieves them. The priest adds that he sold his soul so the devil would guide him to Christ. And fortunately, he met Christ's reincarnation. Not long after, they discover a room full of crosses and religious and satanic statues. The priest informs them that they must leave as it's not safe for them, especially for Tommy. However, Ritter stops him and asks him about the whereabouts of the children he supposedly killed. Ritter comments on how the priest takes a strange interest in an unholy place under the subterranean, just like the one where they are. The priest immediately knows something is up. He informs everyone that Ritter is possessed, which is confirmed when his voice suddenly changes into something demonic when the priest approaches him with a Latin prayer and a cross. In Belzebuth's demonic voice, Ritter yells at them that he will kill them all. The ground shakes, and the lights go out as Belzebuth takes over Ritter's body. Fortunately, they have colored smoke sticks, helping them to see in the dark. They prepare for an attack as they hear Belzebuth growling like an animal while hiding in the shadows. However, Ritter suddenly appears from behind with an axe and kills one of the priest's men, prompting Anne to run away with Tommy. After that, he tases the priest, before knocking Franco unconscious. Anne screams in fear and worry as she sees Ritter following her. Tommy closes his eyes after seeing Belzebuth momentarily turning into his demonic form. Anne and her son come out of the underground tunnel as the sun rises, but Ritter still chases them. Anne has no choice but to stop running for her son's sake when Ritter pulls his trigger in the air. Ritter holds her at gunpoint, but his wife's voice echoes in his head, together with his partner stopping him. Fortunately, Ritter fights back the devil in him and returns to himself. He kneels down and begs his partner to help him. The partner embraces him in a hug in return, calming his longtime friend. Suddenly, two gunshots are heard, and Ritter smirks at his partner, revealing that Belzebuth is still in him and he just pretended to be Ritter to kill him. As the partner drops dead, the possessed Ritter snatches Tommy away from his mother and tries to gouge his eyes out. Fortunately, Anne recovers and knocks him unconscious with a rock, and the rest regain consciousness. They put Ritter back into that unholy place, where the priest informs everyone that they must perform an exorcism, or Belzebuth will continue coming back for Tommy. They use the dead man's blood to draw symbols on the door. They also cover the statues with white clothing and lock the priest with Tommy to keep him safe from danger and evil. The priest blesses the water first, before giving it to Franco, who works as an agent from the Vatican's Paranormal Forensic Division. Franco's men put Ritter on the cross before nailing his hands, while Franco performs the exorcism with Anne. Franco pours the holy water on his head as he finishes the prayer. Suddenly, a large mass appears in Ritter's stomach. They all back away in shock and fear, but they remain praying. However, this only angers Belzebuth, so he attacks Franco's men with the white clothing to cover the statues. Belzebuth laughs as he hears the screams of pain of the men, before throwing them out of the room. Anne and Franco continue the ritual when the heavy cross that Ritter is crucified on suddenly levitates. Ritter opens his eyes, still in the devil's possession, before the cross suddenly falls to the ground, breaking it and freeing Ritter. Belzebuth gets up, takes a stake out of his hand, and stabs Franco with it. Seeing this, Anne tries to escape, but the door leading to the next room closes. The devil then moves on to Anne, grabs her by the neck, not her sexy body, and reveals that the priest has been sacrificing children to break his pact with the devil. Fortunately, before Belzebuth kills her, the priest appears from behind with blood on his hands, presumably from Tommy. With the blood of Christ, the priest successfully extracts Belzebuth from Ritter and transfers the devil into a large stone, imprisoning him for eternity. After the exorcism, Ritter returns to his old self while Franco regains consciousness. The film ends with Franco reporting to the Vatican about the exorcism and saying that the priest's whereabouts will remain unknown for everyone's safety. He also shows them the bloody dagger used by the priest on Tommy, confirming that the child is the new Messiah. It reveals that the priest only cut Tommy's hand to get his blood, and the child remains unharmed. Meanwhile, Ritter finally makes his peace with the Lord. After praying to the lives lost during the ritual, Anne and Ritter bomb the underground tunnel, so no one will free the devil. This is Daniel CC Movie Channel. Stay safe and enjoy your day.